السلام عليكم ولادي وبناتي، كل عام وانتم بخير، رمضان كريم عليكم يا رب ان شاء الله. This lecture will be the second part for the same chapter, chapter 8, scheduling, and I will present the second part of this chapter, which is titled is sequencing, and this is will be lecture number 11. After Dr. Tariq finished from part 1, the current page has a certain information about the definition of the concept of sequencing. Sequencing here, it means that in case of the company has received number of orders, so it's under problem because it needs to understand which one of these orders received will be start first to be entered inside the workstation to start the process. Okay, so the company will find different type of priority rules. The company already has different type of options, and these options like the first come of these orders, first serve, or maybe the shortest processing time needed to start and to finish, maybe start to be first, or maybe the earliest due dates needed to choose the orders needed to process first based on which one of these orders needed to deliver it first. Okay, and you'll find that they already the company has different type of options, but it needs to select the order in which jobs will be processed, okay, based on these rules which presents now. The rules generally assume that the job setup cost is independent of processing sequence. Please take care. Before starting these orders to start the process, the company should be prepared its machines to be ready, and in case of one of them needed to maintain or a certain numbers of these machines needed to spare parts, to change it or anything need of maintenance system, so it should be take all its considerations to be sure that all the machines inside this factory needed to use it to start the process these orders received, all of them they are ready to start the process without problems through processing time, and to be sure that there is a small thing operation system should be done without breakdowns or without any problems for any machines through the time of system of processing. Okay, so the job system cost is independent of processing sequence, because sequence here is concentrated on the times. We will not calculate any cost. So the job setup cost, it means that the cost will be used to prepare the machines to be under safety levels, and it's ready for using it in the processing system without achieving any problems through the operating system. Okay, the second is the job time here. The job time here means that the time needed for setup and processing of a job. It means the time for ranking these jobs based on the FCFS, or based on the shortest processing time, or based on this earliest due dates, should be determined and should be clarified, and the time needed to process to start and to finish each one of these orders should be determined before the orders start to process. Okay, this page has different type of rules. The company can choose between them to start the process of the orders. Okay, so here there is priority rules as a title. You will find that maybe the company can choose the first order come, first serve, like here, or maybe the company can choose the second criteria, which refers to SPT, which means the choosing the order which has the shortest processing time to start with it first. Another option for these rules, which is EDD, and this refers to the orders which has the earliest due dates to deliver it first. Other type of these rules like CR, critical ratio, or S/O or slack the operation, or rush in case of the emergency orders received. Yes, all of them, they are priorities rules, and the company has a right to choose any one of these options to serve its orders. Okay, in this chapter, bismillah, we will concentrate on the first come first serve, the SPT and the EDD, and it will be explained in the next page using a certain problem and the solution for them. This page introduce a certain assumptions about how the company can choose one of the priority rules like FCFS or SPT or EDD. To choose between them, the company should has a certain assumptions, should follow it. Okay, what about these assumptions? The first is the set of jobs or orders should be known before taking actions to start the process its orders. So it means no new news, no new orders arrive after processing begins. So the company will identify a certain number of orders, say accepted 5 orders, okay? So no, and starting its processing system, so no new orders can be accepted, okay? The second is no jobs are cancelled. In case of the company accepted 5 orders to start the process, so it should be under its responsibility to process all these orders, and no one can be cancelled. Okay, the second assumption is the setup times are independent of processing time and deterministic. It means the time needed to start and to prepare the factory to be ready to start the process should be identified. And the second is each one of the orders will be entered to the workstation to start the process. Its time is dependent from the other orders. Okay, so order A needs 2 days to start and to finish. Okay, the second orders may be needed 5 days to start and to finish. Each one of them is independent, okay, of processing time. The third is that there will be no interruptions in processing. What do you mean by this, no interruptions? It means smoothing processing system, okay, which refers to that all the machines should be under maintaining system before the processing system starts, and no way for achieving this machine breakdowns or any accidents through processing, because the company take under considerations to maintain all its machine and be ready to be used through processing without achieving any problems. Okay, and you will find that the concept of sequence, which refers to the order of processing, can be very important. It means that weak or barless means that the order of processing can be very important. The meaning of important means that weak or barless of what? Of the cost associated with job switching of process, because the sequence here will be work around the times of processing. We will not mention any data about the cost of waiting the jobs of entering the jobs in the processing system. The second is idle time at work centers. Also, there is no here. There is no calculations about what the idle time will be achieved at the workstations, because the first order maybe needs 2 days to start and to finish. So the second orders will wait till the first order finished, and then it will be entered to the workstation. But here we will not calculate. We will not calculate the idle time at work centers. In case of there is time not used or slack times, we will not calculate this type of data. We will not calculate the cost associated of jobs waiting tea processing. We will not calculate any data about the idle the work centers. Okay. The current page. We'll concentrate on the sequencing rules which are used to select which one of the orders received should be start first to be processed. Like here, the FCFS, the first come first served, the SPT or the shortest processing time orders will be start first, or the EDD means that the orders which has the earliest due date will be start first. Okay, and take care about a certain notion here: the job sequence, the processing time, the due date, or which means the delivery date, will be arranged each time according to each rule. Take care about this statement and this note. Okay, and this will be identified and more clear in case of providing the example and start to solve it. The current page has a certain example which assume that a company received 6 jobs or orders to be processed at a work center or workstation or factory according to data given in the following table. You will find that this table consists of 3 columns. The first column, its title is job sequence. Job sequence, it means that these orders A, B, C, D, E, F, it's arrived according to this sequence given or written in this column. A arrived first, and then B arrived, and then C arrived, and then D arrived, and then E arrived, and then F. Okay. The second column has data about processing time, which measured using number of days. A as job number one or first order, A needs 2 days to process. Order B needs 8 days to process. C needs 4 days to process. Order D needs 10 days to process. Order E needs 5 days to process, and order F needs 12 days to process. The third column, according to data given in this table, its title is due dates or the time needed to deliver these orders. According to this data, you will find order A needs to deliver at day 7. Order B needs to deliver at the day 16. Order C needs to deliver at the day 4. Order D needs to deliver at the day of 17. Order E needs to deliver at the day of 15. And order F needs to deliver at the day of 18. Okay. After we have explaining these columns, now what about the requirements needed? According to this data given here, the company has a certain number of orders according to this sequence given. and the processing time and its due dates for delivering time days. The company needs to compare between three types of sequence rules, which is the first come first serve FCFS, or the shortest processing time or SPT, or the EDD, or the earliest due dates. Okay. To compare between them, the company will depend on three types of averages or measurements of effectiveness, which is the average flow time, the average days late, the average number of jobs at work center for each of these rules. Okay. And the company here will work under a certain assumption, which is these jobs or orders arrived in the order shown in the table. Means that order A, then B, then C, then D, then E, and then F. So based on this data and based on these requirements, the company needs to choose the better one of this type of criteria or sequencing rules according to this three type of measurements: average flow time, average days late, average number of jobs at work center for each of these rules, and then it will find the better options to follow it. Okay. The solution for this type of problem will start from the next page direct. The data here inside this page has certain information about, in case if you needed to apply the rules FCFS or SPT or EDD, we should understand a certain information here. What about it? The first is here is you have to prepare this table or empty table like here with this title. Okay, you are prepared 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 columns. The first column, its title is job sequence. The second column title is processing time. The third column is the flow time. The fourth column is due date or delivery time. The column number 5 refers to days late, or the number of days maybe company delay for delivering its orders, which refers to the same meaning, the tardiness or days late. Okay, so this is the first. In case of this company needs to choose between the FCFS, the SPT, and the EDD, it should prepare three tables like this table. Okay, it will prepare three tables from this current one. Okay, so one table for FCFS, the second table with the same columns, with the five columns, the second table will apply the concept of SPT, the third table you should prepare to apply the third criteria or the third rule, which is EDD. This is the first. Okay. Okay, what about the notes here should be used? The first, in case of the company needs to use FCFS as a criteria, so it will start to prepare the sequence of jobs. It will start with this type of column number 1, and it will write here the job sequence according to the given in the table. Okay, and according to this job sequence, it should complete data for the other two columns like here. According to job sequence here, say job A, what about its processing time and what about its due date? Then job or order B, what about its processing time, what about its due dates? This is according to the data given. In case of job C, what about its processing time? What about its due dates? And you have to complete it till the end one. What happened in other type? In other type, in case of the company needs to apply the second criteria, which is SPT. What happened here? Shortest processing time. So the company here should, the company should prepare first the, to complete the column which is processing time first, okay? From the shortest, yes, SPT, shortest processing time. So you have to complete the processing time first. It starts from the shortest time till the longest time, okay? This is first. And after completing this processing time, you will return back to ask yourself, what about the data job sequence and what about the due dates? These three columns should be used in for each one to complete in each one of these criteria. And this is will be more clarified according to the example. You understand? So what about the third rule, which is EDD? EDD, it means that we needed to start first to complete this, this data based on EDD. It means the earliest due dates. The earliest due dates, it means that the column of due dates should be start to complete it first. You have to start from the shortest time to deliver till the longest time. Okay, and then you have to complete the second and the third column, job sequence and processing time. And then you will complete, calculate, you will calculate the flow time by yourself, and you will calculate the days late by yourself by using a certain, by using a certain rule, which is, the days late here has a certain point, which is, the days late will be zero. Listen, the days late will be zero if the result of the subtraction between two types of columns, column number 3 minus column number 4, in case of the results is negative, so you will write zero, not write negative. You will write only the data in case of this subtraction is positive only, okay? So in case of the, in case of the flow time is 10 days and the due dates needed to level after 17, so 10 minus 17, the results will be negative 7. This means that the company already finished from processing these orders after 10 days and the company needed to deliver it after 17 days. So the company here subtract 10 minus 17, it will be minus 7. Minus 7 here means that there is a negative sign, and this negative sign will not be negative 7. You will write against it, you will write 0, which refers to the company has no delaying time because already it's finished these orders before the time of delivering, okay? What's the opposite? The opposite here is, in case of the company complete these orders, order A completed after 17 days, but the time to deliver it is 10 days, okay? So 17 as flow time minus due dates as 10 days, 17 minus 10 will be equal 7 plus 7. What do you mean by this plus 7? Means that the company delays for delivering these orders 7 days. It means the company take more time after the time of delivering, okay? So here you will write plus 7, okay? And after preparing each one of this table for each criteria, for each rule, one for the FCFS, one for the and one for the shortest processing time and one for the EDD, then the company will depend on the sum of processing time column and the flow time column summation and the days late submission for this column. And then it will be started to measure its effectiveness, measurements. By calculating LiDAR requirements in the problem, calculate the average flow time, calculate the average tardiness. The tardiness here, it means that the total of days late. And the third, you have to calculate the average number of jobs at the work center. To calculate the average flow time will be equal the total of flow time, the total of flow time over the number of jobs sequence. Okay, the second average tardiness or the total of days late over the number of job sequence also. But the average number of jobs at the work center will be equal the total flow time over the total processing time. This is all we need to prepare this table first, to complete it first, and then you have to use the data inside the table after completing it to measure these three averages based on each criteria. Okay, and what happened at the end, we will I will explain it at the end of this of the problem. Okay, start the company here. We'll start to apply the data of FCFS or the first come first serve. Take care about the notes here before starting to complete this data. Rank job sequence, first come first serve. So you have to complete first the rank the job sequence or the order sequence, and then complete the processing time and due date, because we said before in the previous page three columns should be prepared first, which is job processing, job sequence, and due dates. Each time you have to start with these three columns first, and then you can calculate the flow time and you can calculate the days late. Okay, okay, you will find here, because the FCFS, it means that the first come first serve. So we have to start with the job sequence, like it's written here, rank this column first, rank the job sequence first, and then rank column 2, like it's written here, then rank column 2, okay, and then rank, at the same time, rank due dates or column number 4, okay, like it's written above the table here. Okay, what happened here? Here you will find that I'm starting with the job sequence A, okay, according to them. Okay, what about the time needed? Okay, and then B, and then order C, and then D, and then E, and then F. Do you understand? This is your job sequence according to the given in the table. Okay, A, then B, then C, then D, then E, then F. Okay, after writing this job sequence, you have to complete the processing time and the due dates for each one of these job sequence. Okay, so A, according to data given, needs 2 days to start to finish, and it needs to deliver after 7 days. What about for order B? It needs 8 days to process, and it will deliver after 16 days. Okay, what about for C? C needs 4 days to start to finish, and it will need to deliver after 4 days. What about for order D? Needs 10 days to process, and needs to deliver after 17 days. What about for order E? It needs 5 days to process and to finish, and need to deliver after 15 days. What about for the last one, order F? Needs 12 days to start the process and finish, and needs to deliver after 18 days. Do you understand the meaning here? Please take care. I'm starting with the three columns, which are used from the table given direct. In case of the rule here needs to apply, it's the first come first serve. So we have rank the column of job sequence, or order processing sequence, like here we have to prepare it first, and then we are starting to stop. What about the first order A? What about its processing time? And what about its due dates? Then order B, what about its processing time? What about its due dates? Then C, what about its processing time? And what about its due dates? And the next order still, order number F, what about its processing time? And what about its due dates time? Okay. After completing them, now you have to understand that the summation of processing time is 41. Okay? Okay. By adding 2 plus 8 plus 4 plus 10 plus 5 plus 12 will be 41 days. Okay? What's for the next year? Okay. Okay. Now you need to complete the column number 3, which is titled flow time, and the column number 5, which is days late. Okay? Flow time here, it will be start by using this type of data, which is, yes, the first is order A needs 2 days, so it will start and finish after 2 days. Okay, flow time. So the first orders in all the criteria, its processing time should be equal to the flow time. Okay. What about for order B? Order B needs 8 times to start to finish. Okay, it will be enter to the workstation after 2 days of A. So the flow time will be 2 days of A plus 8 of B will be 10 days. So till now, the workstation works 10 days to complete order A and order B. Okay, C needs 4 days. So 4 plus 10 days, it means that 10 plus 4 equal 14 days, and then the company or this factory works till now 14 days to complete order A, B, and C. What about for D? D needs 10 days to start to finish. So 10 plus 14, it will be equal 24 days. What about for job or order E? It needs 5 days to start to finish, so 5 plus 24, it will be equal to 29. And this order F needs 12 days to start to finish, so 12 plus 29, it will be equal to 41 days. Please take care here, flow time as accumulated days, to understand what about the total times needed to start all, have to start the orders from A to F, what about the total time needs to complete all these orders. The last one of this 21 plus 12 in the first in the last one of these orders, which is order F, needed 41, the last one. Take care about the circle here written. Yes, 41 and the total of the processing time should be equal in all the criteria in FCFS, and you will find it in the SPT, and you will find already the same in the third criteria, which is the EDD. Take care about it. The processing time, 41 as a total, will be equal the last orders time needed to complete it. 41 as the order F, okay, the last one, flow time, will be equal the shortest processing time for all the orders. Okay, this is one notes should be equal, should be equal. Okay, and what about the summation for the flow time? The summation of this column will be equal to 2 plus 10 plus 14 plus 24 plus 29 plus 41 will be equal 120 days. Do you understand? Okay, what about for the days late? The days late here is the last column, or column number 5. You will find here, it's calculated based on the subtraction of flow time minus the column of due dates for each one of these orders, okay? You will subtract 2 minus 7. 2 minus 7, it means that minus 5. I will not write minus 5, but I will write direct 0. Like we said, this days late will be 0. If the results of the subtraction between two columns, column number 3 minus column number 4, is negative, Okay. What about for the second? The second for job B, the flow time equal 10 days. So the company can complete this order after 10 days. But it will be delivered after 16 days. So 10 minus 16, it will be minus 6. I will not write minus 6 because the company is not delaying. Okay? No delaying time. Okay? But already the orders is finished and inside the warehouse till the time of delivering, minus 6. Okay, so I will not write 6, minus 6, but I will write 0. In the third orders, order C is different. Why? Because the company will complete this order after 14 days, but the customer need to deliver it after 4 days. You understand? So 14 minus 4 will be 10 plus 10. This means the company here delaying for delivering these orders for 10 days. Deliver 10 days to deliver it. What about for order G? Order G, the company already finished these orders after 24. But the time to delivering is 17. So the company here, there is delaying time. 24 minus 17, it will be plus 7. The company also is not deliver its this order D, and it delays 7 days to deliver. Okay, plus 7. What about for order E? Order E will finish after 29 days. Also, the customers need to deliver it after 15 days. So you will find 29 minus 15, it will be equal plus 14. The company delayed for delivering these orders for 14 days, and the result is plus 14. What about for order F? Order of F here, the company will complete this order after 41 days, but the time to deliver it should be after 18 days. So 41 minus 18, the results will be plus 23, and this means that the company will delay to deliver this for 20 days. Okay. What about the total? What about the total for this delays late column? 0 plus 0 plus 10 plus 7 plus 14 plus 23, it will be 54 days. Okay. After completing this table, you will start to calculate the measures of effectiveness. Okay, and this action will be in each one of this rule. Okay, the first one is calculating the average flow time. How calculating this average flow time? Like the equation mentioned in the previous page, it will be the total flow time, which is equal 120 over the number of orders received, 1 A, then B, C, D, E, F. It will be 6 orders. So I will divide the flow time, the summation of flow time, which is equal 120 days, over the number of jobs, which is equal 6. It will be 20 days. What about for the second? The second measurement is the average tardiness. Tardiness here, it means that the day is late. Okay, the average times of delaying. You will find that I will use the total of these days list, which is equal 54 at column number 5, over also the number of these jobs sequence, which is equal 6. So the results will be 9 days. What about for the last one of these average required, which is average number of jobs at the work center? You will find that it be equal 120, which is flow time over the processing time here, and then will be 2.93 jobs. Okay, take care about it in each time. In case of the problems given, needed from you to calculate two criteria, so you have like FCFS and SPT to choose between them, which one of them is better to follow. So you have to prepare this table two times, one for FCFS and one for SPT rule. In case of like this problem, the company has three options, FCFS or SPT or EDD, so you have to prepare this type of table three times, and after finish that, you have to calculate its measures here of effectiveness, the average flow time, the average tardiness, and the average number of days, and please don't round any numbers, leave it at the same, because this is time, okay? What happened in this type of page? You will find we needed to apply the second rule, which is SPT or shortest processing time. Shortest processing time here, it means that we needed to rank the job sequence. Listen, we needed to rank the job sequence and the due dates based on processing time. What do you mean by this? We said before that there are three columns should be start with it first. Job sequence, processing time, and due dates. Now we needed to rank this table based on SPT. It means we needed to start rank first the processing time, from the shortest time to the longest time. And then we will rank the job sequence and the due dates based on this job sequence ranking. Okay, you will find above the table written here according to this shape, which refers to rank this column first according to processing time, and you will find then rank column 1 and rank column 4. Okay, we will start direct to solve it, to prepare this table, and please don't forget, after completing this job sequence, processing time, and due dates, you have to calculate the flow time by yourself, and you have to calculate the days late, okay? And then measuring the effective the measures of effectiveness, like the three average calculated in the previous page. Now I will start to complete this. Okay, the shortest processing time, you will find that we will prepare it from the shortest time to the longest time. Yes, 2 then, according to data given in the table of the problem, 2 then 4, then 5 days, then 8 days, then 10 days, then 12 days. What happened here? Here we needed to work under the second criteria, which is shortest processing time. And this means that we have to start to complete this table based on this shortest processing time. So I will stand at this column, processing time, column number 2, and I will rank the data given in the problem, rank it from the shortest time till the longest time. Do you understand? Okay. After preparing this processing time, so you have to rank column number 1, job sequence, and column number 4, due dates, based on the ranking of this processing time. What about for job sequence? Refers to job A, and what about its due dates? It's 7 days. Then what about the second order or job? Is order C, and what about its due dates, which is equal 4 days? What about for the next job, job E, and it needs to deliver after 15 days? What about in the next? Yes, job B or order B, and it needs to deliver after 16 days. What about after order B, then order D, and it needs to deliver after 17 days? What about after order D? You will find that order F, and it needs to deliver after 18 days. Now we are applying the second rule, or the second criteria, which is the shortest processing time. We are starting to complete the processing time column first, from the shortest to the longest time, and then completing the job sequence and the due dates columns, okay, according to processing time, okay. And after calculating it, we needed to find what about the flow time like the previous. Okay, the first order here is order A, which has 2 days to start to finish. So direct, like we mentioned in the previous page, yes, the processing time is equal the flow time only for the first job only. Okay, what about for the next? The next here is after A is finished using 2 days, then C needs 4 days, so 2 days plus 4 to C will be equal 6 days. It means that till now the factory works 6 days to complete job A and C, and then I will add 5 days to start to complete the order E, and then 6 plus 5 will equal 11 days. And then entering the next order B, needs 8 days to start to finish, so 11 plus 8, it will be equal 19 days. And then enter the order D, which needs 10 days to start to finish, so 10 plus 19 will be equal 29 days. And the last order, which is F, needs 12 days to start to process and to finish, so 12 plus 29 will be equal 41. Please take care again. The processing time, which equal 2 plus 4 plus 5 plus 8 plus 10 plus 12 equal 41 days, like the previous page. And at the same time, the last order for the job for the flow time column should be equal 41. Okay, so this is will be indicate to that your solution till now is right. Okay, so please take care this tool which has a certain circle here should be equal. Okay, and the submission for the flow time column, which is equal 2 plus 6 plus 11 plus 19 plus 29 plus 41 will be equal 100.08. Okay, now we needed to calculate the column number 5, which is days late. Days late, like we said before, it will be equal the subtraction of the column of flow time minus the column of due dates. So I will start with the first, which is the order A needs to finish and is ready to deliver after 2 days. But at the same time, the customer need to deliver it after 7 days. So 2 minus 7, it will be minus 5. We will not write minus 5. We will write 0. And this 0 refers to that the company has no days late, because already the orders is inside the warehouse after 2 days, and wait till the time of delivering after 7 days, and then no problems for the company. What about for the second, for order C? C will be completed after 6 days as flow time, and needed to deliver after 4 days. Yeah, so here 6 minus 4, it will be plus 2. This means these orders will be has delaying late for 2 days. Okay, what about for order E? Order E will be completed after 11 days. Okay, but the customers needed to receive it after 15 days. So these orders already will be inside the warehouse from day number 11, but it will be wait till the customers receive it after 15 days. So 11 minus 15 will be equal minus 4. I will not write minus 4, but I will write 0. Okay. What about for order B? Order B will finished after 19 days. But the customers need to receive it or should be delivered after 16 days. So 19 minus 16, it will be plus 3. So the company will be delay this order for 3 days, plus 3. What about for order D? Order D will be finished after 29 days, but the customers wants to deliver it after 17 days. Okay? So in 29 minus 17, it will be plus 12 days the company delaying to deliver this order. What about for order F? Other F will be completed after 41 days, but it should be delivered after 18. So how we can do it? 41 minus 18 refers to that the company will delay to deliver these orders for plus 23 days. Okay. According to the assumption for the delays late column, you will find that 0, plus 2, plus 0, plus 3, plus 12, plus 23 will be equal plus 40 days. Now, I will start to measure the effectiveness measurements. The first one, which is average flow time, and average flow time is equal the summation of the flow time over the number of job sequence. So 108 over 6 will be 18 days. The second measurement is the average of tardiness or average days late will be equal the number of days tardiness, which is equal 40, okay, the total is 40, over the number of the job sequence, which is 6 jobs, so it will be 6.67, and you will find that I'm leaving this decimal numbers. You can round it to decimal numbers, yes, 6.67. And the third one of this measure, which is average number of jobs at the work center, you will find that the flow time, the summation of flow time, 108 over the total of processing time, which is equal 41, the results will be 2.63 jobs. Okay, so now we have finished from the second rule. Okay, and now we will start to complete the table to prepare the EDD or earliest due dates. And here you will find that take care about the notes here written. Now, because we needed to complete this data based on the earliest due dates first. So you have to start first with the due days or the due dates column first, and then you can rank the job sequence and processing time based on these due dates. Do you understand? Okay. So like it's written above this table before starting, what about this these shapes which are derived from the rank this column first, yes, like it here, okay, in the column number 4, and then rank column 1 and 2, you can rank the job sequence and the processing time to complete it, okay. Okay, now, before starting, you have to understand, after preparing the three columns, job sequence, processing time, and days late, or due late days, you can calculate the flow time and calculate the days late. I will start first with the column number 4. Yes, the first earliest due dates. Please take care. You will start to rank this column from the shortest time or the shortest time to deliver these orders till the longest time to deliver it. Okay, so according to this rank, you will find that 4, then 7 days, then 15 days, then 16 days, then 17 days, then 18 days. Do you understand what happened here? We are ranking the due dates, which measured by days, numbers. We are ranking it from the shortest, earliest time to deliver till the longest time to deliver these orders, okay? After preparing them and ranking them, okay, I will start to rank at the same time the job sequence column and processing time column. Okay, I will start here first. You will find that the order which needs to deliver after 4 days is the job C, okay? And at the same time needs to process time 4 days. What about the second order needed to deliver? is the order A, which needs to deliver after 7 days and needed 2 days to process. Okay, what about the next order? Order E, which needs to deliver after 15 days and needed 5 days to process. What's the next? Order B, which needs to deliver after 16 days and needed to process of her 8 days. Then order D, which needs to deliver after 17 days and needs 10 days to start, to complete, and to finish. And the last order is order number F, which needs 18 days to deliver it and needs 12 days to process. Okay, now we are completing the main three columns: job sequence, processing time, and due dates. Okay, after calculating or after preparing it, after ranking, we needed to calculate what about the submission for the processing time, which is equal 4 plus 2 plus 5 plus 8 plus 10 plus 12, which is equal 41. Each time, according to this type of example, you will find, because the processing time, its submission is 41, which is should be equal, processing time in each criteria should be equal 41. For FCFS, the processing time is equal 41. And the last one of this jobs should be equal 41. In the flow time column, okay. In the second criteria, shortest processing time, you will find the processing time submission for the column of processing time, which is equal also 41. And the last order in the job sequence also, it needs 41 days as flow time. Okay, and like here in the third one of this criteria, you will find that yes, the submission for the processing time here, which is equal 41, and the last one here for the flow time of job F also needs 41 days. Okay, this is will be as indicator to be sure that your solution steps is right and there is no problem. Okay, after this we needed to find what about the flow time calculation. Okay, I will start with the first one. Order C needs 4 days to start and to finish, and we said before that the first job, its processing time should be equal its flow time for the first job sequence only. Okay, and then after finish that, we will enter the second order A, which needs 2 days to finish. So 2 plus 4 days of C will be equal 6 days. Till now the factory finished or complete to work 6 days, and then we will enter order E, which needs 5 days. So the total time will be equal 5 plus 6 will be equal 11 days. And then entering the order B, which needs 8 days to start to finish. So 8 plus 11 will be 19 days. And then entering order D, which needs 10 days to start and to finish. So 10 plus 19 will be equal 29. And this data for the last order here, which is order F, it needs 12 days to start and to finish. So 12 plus 29 will be equal 41. After calculating this flow time, I will find the submission for this column, which refers to equal 4 plus 6 plus 11 plus 19 plus 29 plus 41 will be equal 110. Okay, after calculating this column, we needed to complete the last column here, which is days late, column number 5. And we will start to subtract the column of flow time minus due dates late days by subtracting the flow time minus the due days late for each one of these orders. I'm starting with the first. 4 days as flow time minus 4 as due dates. You will find 4 minus 4 equals 0. It means that this order C needs to start and to finish 4 days, And at the same time, the customers needed that to deliver it after 4 days. So 4 minus 4 will be equal 0, no delaying time. What about for order A? Order A will be finished after 6 days, but it needs to deliver after 7 days. So this order will be after finished inside the warehouse till day number 7 to deliver. So 6 minus 7, it will be minus 1. I will not write minus 1 because there is no delaying. I will write it 0. What about for order E? Order E will be finished after 11 days. But it will be finished after 11 days and needs to deliver after 15 days. So these orders, after finished at day number 11, it will be inside the warehouse till it will be delivered after number of days, after 15 days, day number 15. Okay, so 11 minus 15 will be equal minus 4. I will not write minus 4, but I will write 0. What about for order B? Order B needs to finish after 19 days, but the customers needs to deliver it after 16 days. So 19 minus 16, it will be plus 3. So this is refers to that the company here will delay to deliver these orders for 3 days. What about for order D? Order D will finish after 29 days, but the customers need to deliver it after 17 days. So 29 minus 17 will equal plus 12, and this refers to the company also delayed for 12 days to deliver this order, plus 12. What about for order F? Order F will finish after 41 days, although the customers needed to receive it after 18 days. So 41 minus 18, which is equal plus 23. This means that also the company delays to deliver this order for 23 days. Okay. What about the total days for this days late? You will find that 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 3 plus 12 plus 23, it will be equal 38. Now we can start to measure the measurement of effectiveness by calculating all of this data in the table. And now we will start with the first one, average flow time, which refers to the summation of flow time, which is equal 110 over the number of job sequence 6, which is equal 18.33 days. Take care. Yes, we are approximated this decimal numbers to two decimal numbers here. Yes, and the second measurement is the average tardiness or the average days late. You will find that the total days late is equal 38 over the number of job sequence, which is equal 6, so it will be equal 6.33 days. And the measurement number 3, which is average number of jobs at the work center, will be equal the total of flow time over the processing time, will be equal 2.68 jobs. So after calculating all this type of data, now we will prepare a certain table to include all the measurements results. Okay, yes, the summary of these three rules. Okay, you will find that, yes, here the first column has the three rules. The first, which is FCFS, the second is SPT, and the third, which is EDD. And I will use the data which is written under each one of the previous tables. Okay, the average flow time, the average tardiness, and the average number of jobs at the work center. The three measurements which are already calculated at the end of each one of the three previous tables. Okay, and then I will write its data here. What about for the if CFS, it's average flow times days 20, and average tardiness is 9 days, and average number of jobs at the work center is 2.93 jobs. For the SPT rule, you will find that the average flow time, according to data calculated, 18 days. The average tardiness is 6.67 days, and its average number of jobs at the work center is 2.63. What about for the EDD results? Three measurements. Under the average flow time equal 18.33, under the average tardiness equal 6.33, and the average number of jobs at the work center equal 2.68. So now we are gathering all the data results for the measurements of effectiveness inside this table and based on each one of these rules used. Okay, what about here? We needed to understand what about the conclusion needed to understand these concepts. You will find that, yes, I will start here under the average flow time. Okay, which one of them is the lowest time needed? 20, 18, or 18.33? 18 is the lowest times. Okay, 18 days. Yes, 18 is the related or closest to the SPT or shortest process time. Shortest processing time. Okay, so shortest processing time is better in case of we needed to work under the average flow times. Okay. What about for the average tardiness? The average tardiness here is 9 days for FCFS or 6.67 here or 6.33. You will find that what about the shortest time here for the average tardiness, for the delaying time, which one of them is the lowest time to delay? Okay, you will find that the criteria, which is earliest due dates, is the lowest time here for in case of comparing these numbers with the other two numbers, 9, 6.67 or 6.33. No, 6.33 is better. So in case of the company needs to follow or to choose the average tardiness points as a measurement of effectiveness, so it should use the earliest due dates, because it can presents the lowest time as the average tardiness or the average delays time. What about in the third column? In the third column, you will find that here the average number of jobs at the work center. Yes, 2.93, 2.63, 2.68. What about which one of them is the shortest or the lowest number, the average number of the jobs at the work centers? You will find that 2.63 is the lowest one. Number of jobs is the lowest number of jobs will be related to the shortest processing time. So in case of the company needs to follow the average number of jobs at the work center as the measurement of effectiveness, so it should follow the shortest processing time, because it refers to the lowest number of jobs in the work centers. You will find here SPT has more than one advance according to the lowest time for the average flow time and lowest number of the average of jobs at the work center. So maybe the company, in case of it needs to benefit from the average flow time for its jobs and the average number of the jobs at the work center, it can follow the SPT. And you'll find that the FCFS has no advance for each one of these three measurements of effectiveness. You understand? So here you will find that it's not a condition each time to find that SPT is better. We cannot say in each time the EDD is better. No, we can't say that, because this is will be refers to the data given, and based on the data given and based on the calculations for the three measurements of effectiveness, you can choose between them and to choose the better one. Okay. So the SPT rule is a superior here, or it's the better one, because the SPT rule always results in the lowest average completion flow time. It can result in lower in process inventory. According to this data, I'm explaining what's the contents of this summary of these three rules according to data given in this problem. Okay, because it's it often provides the lowest average tardiness. Okay. it can result in better customer service levels, okay? And at the same time, it always involves a lower average number of the jobs at the work center. It also minimizes the downstream of idle time, although we are not calculating it, but because you will find that comparing with 2.63 and 2.68 and 2.93, it will be better to lower the time and to lower the number of jobs taking time inside the work centers, okay? My sons and daughters, based on this summary of these three rules, this lecture now is finished, and we will meet again in the next lecture, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.